So I was just sat down, and I, in my job, I have to do a bit of editing of all kinds of shit. Everything from video to fucking audio to bloody photo to just about anything. Whatever you can do, we try and do it somehow. We'll find a way. And so I had a track for one of the services, and it was the 1812 Overture. Now, I don't know about whether you know of that track, but it's the 1812, being that it's Tchaikovsky's 1812, a phenomenally awesome piece of music. Well, in my personal opinion, I fucking love it. I always did as a kid, but it's funny, it reminded me when I had to, well, I'd thought, no, fuck it, I'm going to listen to it. Well, I've downloaded it. All I got to do is put it onto a disc for the service, but I thought, fuck, I actually want to listen to it. I haven't heard it in ages. So it used to be just one of my favourites as a kid when I was in orchestra or in wind bands or anything like that, playing 1812. I used to love 1812 Overture. And so I was playing it. It just made me think back to the version I've downloaded has cannons, live cannons. And all it can make me think back to was... first of all, playing it as a kid, you know, in orchestra, and they used to hit drums, you know, it'd be the bass drums, they'd be banging, and that was the cannon fire, you know, the bit where it turns into cannon fire, and it would just be someone hitting the drum. In the orchestras, it would be a couple of people hitting a couple of bass drums, or maybe just one drum, you know, and so it was cool, but you never quite got the effect of an actual cannon going off. And and then I remember playing it in the army, and we've played it now and again. You get just, again, maybe a couple of fucking bass drummers hitting the bass drums, and you get that sort of cannon effect. But then I remember my absolute, like, pinnacle of performing the 1812. For me, it was like the fucking orgasm of ever playing that piece of music. Truly fucking orgasmic. We did a beating the retreat, I think, or was it a mini, I can't remember if it was beating retreat or mini tattoo, for some fucking generals, I think, at, I can't even remember the place we done it at, somewhere in the south of England, and we done it at this, Tidworth, I think it was, it might have been just the mass bands, and it really was mass bands. I can't remember how many bands, it might have been about 8 bands or something like that, or 6 bands, and military bands, and we all fucking lined up across the grass, like fucking full on in front of this building, which was where the fucking generals were going to stand, and all his party, I suppose, and there was fucking, I don't know how many fucking bandsmen there, just all lined in front of this thing, fucking full bands, all deep, and we're lined up, and behind us, like, I don't know, maybe about 20 metres behind the bands, was, now I'm going to say it was about 6 cannons, I could be wrong, it's hard to remember offhand, I know it was definitely more than 4, and they weren't just normal cannons, this wasn't like a couple of little field cannons, this was fucking AS-90 fucking mobile cannons, I'm talking big guns, big fucking artillery, fucking mobile cannons, fucking huge things, and these bastards, huge bloody things, are lined up behind us in a line, and I remember looking at them going, oh my fucking god, I'm in heaven, and we're there playing, rehearsing the pieces, and we're playing away the 1812, and then the fucking guns go off. Oh my fucking god, I fucking wanted to spurt in my pants. It was fucking truly amazing, and it was like ground shakingly amazing, you know, you're stood just in front of these fucking ginormous bastard mobile AS-90 cannons, you know, mobile artillery, and they're fucking booming away while you're playing the music. Oh my god, It was fucking stunning. I loved it. I'm sure there'll be plenty of people who were like, it was fucking shit, Gareth. I felt, truly for me, it was fucking the peak of playing the fucking 1812. Honestly, it was like, and I remember the fucking things going off. And it fucking, the noise, the thud, and then feeling the fucking shockwave, like, just push you in the back. It was fucking stunning. Oh my god, I loved it. It was fucking amazing. I mean, if you ever just listen to the 1812, and just as you're reaching, I mean, just as you're reaching, the cannon's going off, and then just imagine you're stood in front of a fucking mobile cannon. You know, it's fucking outstanding. And it wasn't just a, you know, a little fucking bang of the little cannons you hear on certain 1812 recordings, you know. This was fucking loud, fucking tremendous bangs. It was fucking stunning. It fucking blew me away. I loved it. That always stood out there as a moment that I'll remember of my time frame in the army, you know. It was fucking phenomenally cool. I loved it. I don't remember much else about that being the retreat, truly, honestly, or the mass bands part of it, you know. I don't remember much else. I just remember looking to the left and right of me and seeing absolutely masses of musicians lined up playing, and the only part that really started, that I just truly remember, was looking to the left and right of me, and we're playing the fucking 1812, you know. It was fucking phenomenal, and these fucking huge cannons going off behind me, it was fucking amazing, truly stunning. And to that, I can only say that was my peak of fucking playing the 1812, and I'll always remember that of my, one of my sort of true memories in the army, you know, like that bit that stood out. It's like, yep, playing the 1812 Overture with fucking AS90 land cannon, fucking mobile cannons. Stunning. Truly stunning. And, yeah, it just reminded me of that. Listening to it just took me back a little bit there. Ooh, a bit of fucking old school memory going on. I don't know. It's funny how things remind you, you know? It just takes you back a little bit. There are plenty of other things that take me back, but that truly. So anyway, to that, I thank you, and cheers, Easy. Have a good one.